Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to create this poster from scratch in Canva. So I have a free account and this is just the home page. So all I'm going to do is to go up to create a design and just go down to A4 document. And you can see this opens a brand new window. Now over on the left here, I'm going to search for the various elements that I need. But first of all, we need to go down to the icon called elements. The first thing I'm going to insert is an image. So I'm going to go down to photos and click see all. And then at the top here, I'm going to type in graduate, press enter. And then I'm going to select this free image here. You can tell if they're free or not, because if they're not and you need the pro version, you'll see this little crown here. So I'm just going to drag this image up here. Just pull the corners out until it fits the top of your document. You can move it up and down. You can have as much or as little of this image in here as you like. And we'll leave that there. Then in order to change the color, the slight hue of this image, we're going to go back to elements and we're going to go to lines and shapes. And I'm going to select the square. And then I'm going to move this square over the top of this image. And then I'm going to go up to the color. I'm going to change the color to this purple. And then I'm going to go over to this transparency icon, click on that, and I'm going to turn the transparency down, but it will give that image the right hue for my cover poster. Once I've done that, I'm going to go back and insert the next photograph. So go back to elements, down to photos and click see all. And in this one, I'm going to type study and press enter. Again, you can select from any image. I'm going to select this one here. And then I'm just going to reduce the size of it and go back to elements. And this time I'm going to need a frame. So I'm just going to type in the top here, frames, and click enter. And then we go to the frames here and click see all. Now frames are just basically like a mask and you can put any of these frames in and then you can put images inside these frames. It just acts like a picture frame really. So I'm going to click on the circle and then all I'm going to do is grab my picture and click and drag it over the top of the frame and you can see it inserts that straight away. Now if I want to edit this, just double click on it, then I can pull out my image or reduce the size of it and I can move it around the circle, but it will not move beyond the boundaries of the image because obviously you'll be left with some white areas. Once you're done, just press enter and then I can move that image up here. I'm going to put a border around this image using a circle. So I'm going to go back to my elements, my lines and shapes, click see all, click on the circle, and then I'm going to move this circle over the top of this image. Just make that big enough to stretch over the top. And then I'm going to go to border style, and then I'm going to move my border style up to probably about 18. I'm going to change that border color to purple and change the fill color to transparent. Then I've got that image inside that border. And then if I just click and drag across both of those, both the image and the border, go up to group, select group, and now I can move this round as one element. So now I just want to put some wave type graphics in here with some gradients. So if I go up to my search elements and just type in wave and press enter, I can go to the graphics here and click see all. And from this one, I'm going to select this graphic here and then just pull that out and stretch it across your canvas. Now with this one, we need to send it backwards. You can right click on that image once you've selected it, and then we can go to center back, and then I need to bring it forward. You can also go up to position and then you can keep clicking to front and then just keep kicking back until you get it into exactly the right place. Now I want to change the gradient colors. So we go up to these two colors here, click on this gradient here, click on the purple, and then on this one, I'm going to select from this pink. Now, if you don't see the colors that you want here, just click on this add icon and you'll get the color wheel. And then you can move this slider at the bottom here, and then you can move this slider here to select the color of your choice. Once you're happy, I'm going to select this, hold down my Alt or Option key, click and drag, and you can see I've now made another one. I'm going to change the colors of this one. I'm going to use the lighter purple, and I'm also going to add a color. I'm going to use a nice blue. I'm going to move that across to about there and use that blue. That's not quite working with the purple, so I need to change that purple color to a lighter purple. And actually, I need to change those around. So I'm going to select that one and change that one to the lighter purple. Change this one to the darker blue. So let's add that blue again. Perfect. I'm just going to move that up. Now I'm going to use the rotate icon at the bottom here just to rotate that wave and add a little bit more interest. I can move it left and right as well. I don't need it to fit perfectly. Again, holding down my Alt or Option key, click and drag out another wave. And again, we're going to change those colors. And again, I'm just going to rotate that to add a bit of interest. Finally, because we need this area here white, if I try to reduce the size of this, you can see I'm not going to have any joy with making that section white at the bottom here. So we actually need to put in another one of these because I don't want a straight line across here. So I'm going to press down my Alt or Option key, click and drag out another one, but this time I'm going to change the colors to white on both of the colors so that we get that nice wave effect at the bottom. And again, this is all personal preference. So you can move this exactly where you want it. I think that was better. So we'll move that to there. Perfect. So we need some more graphics at the bottom with gradients. So I'm going to go to the search at the top here and type in gradients. Click on the graphics and click see all. And then I'm just going to zoom down. And I'm going to select this free one here. I'm going to make that a little bit bigger, put that down at the bottom. And once again, we're going to go to the top here and change those colors. I'm just going to keep to the colors that we have been using just to keep that coherent vibe to the whole poster. Maybe change that one to pink. Okay, and then once you're happy, hold down the Alt or Option key and then click and drag out a new gradient. Again, we'll change this color or this color here to blue, and that just makes that a little bit more vibrant. Okay, so now we're going to insert some text, but before I do that, I'm just going to click and drag across everything that we've inserted so far, and I'm going to turn it into a group, and then I'm going to lock it in place. So now none of this background can move, which is really useful because when you go to put the text in, sometimes this all nudges about and it's really annoying. So now let's go to text. So you can put your own text in using these headings here, or you can select from the different options on the menu. So I'm going to use this graphic design one here. And when it's inserted, it's all a complete group. So you can't edit this until you ungroup it. So select it and just go to ungroup. Once you've done that, if you hit this little white icon here, you can then go and edit each little box. When you line up these boxes, you'll see that there's a pink line that appears when it's perfectly lined up, which is really useful. So if you want to edit your text, just double click inside and then enter your text. Now you've got to be careful because if you've still got your cursor on this line here and you go to change the size of your text up here on decrease font size, it will only change the size of the font on that line and not all the other text. So what you do have to do, you can select all the text or you can select Command or Control A, which will select all the text, and then you can reduce the size here or you can just enter the size that you want. Once I've done that, I'm going to go to the color of my text and select white, and then I'm just going to move that down. I'm just going to shift these over. I'm going to move that down to here and that across to here just to move that out of the way. I'm going to reduce the size of that a little bit more and just reduce the size of that box. Maybe just a tad more. There we go. And then move this box up And again, I'm going to line that up. You can see the pink line that appears when I do that. I'm going to go up and change the color again to white and then enter in my text, double click inside. And then again, you can reduce the size of this as well if you want. Command or Control A to highlight the text, and then you can reduce that down. And then we can go up here and do the same. Let's change that to white, change the text, click inside. And then again, we can move this around. If you find you can't move it around, it's because your cursor's inside and it thinks you want to type. So just deselect it, then reselect it. And again, try and line everything up with the text below, just makes it a little bit neater. And then we can now try and pop some text in the center here. So I'm going to use this text box. This text suits me, so I don't have a problem with this text. I'm just going to copy and paste some default text, as I'm sure you don't want to watch me type. There we go, just move this box, my cursor's inside again. So let's reduce the size of this text. And let's just do that by clicking on the reduce font size tool here. And then I'm going to just move this text box in. I'm going to center align it. So click on this alignment tool. And then we'll just move this box down. Now you have to be careful because you have to ensure that you can get three boxes along here. And before we do that, we're just going to give this box a title. So I'm going to copy and paste it, holding down my Alt or Option key, click and drag. And then I'm going to use this text again. And I'm just going to type in my heading. Then I'm going to increase the font size. I'm going to make it bold, and I'm going to change the color to purple. Deselect, reselect, and move. There we go. Once I'm happy with the alignment, I'm going to select both of those, click and drag across them both, select group, and then Alt or Option, click and drag out another one, and again another one. Perfect. Now I'm just going to, now you see at the back here, we haven't quite given ourselves enough room. So what I will do at the end, I'll come back and move this white section so that we can get that title in and it's not quite so close. So once you've inserted them, we want to align all of these. So select them all, go to position, and we want to align them equally. So there's an equal gap between them. So click on horizontally, and then we're going to group them together. Once they're grouped, they're one element, and we need to align them to the center of the page. Now you can use the little pink markers. You can see there, I've now centered it. So let's try and just select that box. There we go. Just click and drag across it, position. And you can see it's perfectly centered. Once you're happy with that, I'm just going to move that box down. Let's just move the whole thing down. Now we're just going to add some lines in the center here. So let's go to Elements, go to Shapes and click on that line. You can see my line appears here. I'm going to change the color of that. So go up to the color of the line. I'm going to pick purple again. I'm going to move that down, and then I'm going to pop that at 90 degrees and pull that down. Now you can see it's lined up with the top. We're going to try and line that up with the bottom as well. Although I'm going to take that up just a little bit. There we go. And then holding down my Alt or Option key while it's selected, click and drag. Now try and place it equally between the text. There we go, perfect. Final thing we need to do is to put some text in at the bottom here. So I'm going to grab this text box, click on it, hold down the Alt or Option key, click and drag out some more text. Reduce the size of this box and do that one more time. So holding down that Alt or Option key, click and drag. And then in here, I'm just going to put my contact information, Command or Control A to select everything. And now just to add a little bit of interest, you can actually just select this text here, reduce the size of that line, and then just select Contact Us and just make that bold and increase the size of it. And then we can move this. If you hold down your Control key, then you'll notice that moving it around is much smoother and not quite so clunky. Let's just deselect that. What I might do is try and line this text up, as I said before, try and do it so that it's actually lined up, so that it's actually lined up with something above. You can see There we go. Pink lines have appeared. It's different. If you hold down your control key, the pink lines disappear. So it is a bit of trial and error. Okay, so let's go on to this one here. Put your cursor inside, Command or Control A. And again, you can make this bigger or smaller. Make that bold, increase the size of it. And again, if you want to change the alignment of this text, select it and go up to the alignment tool. It can be centered or over to the right, and then deselect, reselect that box. And then you can move this box and you can line that up wherever you want. Now this one just bothers me a bit. So what I'm going to do is select it all and just reduce the size of it all. That's better. So let's go ahead and just move this white background. So in order to do that, because we've locked it, double click on it and you'll see this unlock padlock here. Just click on that and you can see all the features come back. So if I just click on the white background and then I can move that round. In fact, it's all grouped together. So don't do that. Go to ungroup. There we go. Deselect. Just select the white one. And then we can move that round where we want to. And I can also rotate it. I'm just going to move this down and I'm just going to move that down. It's a little bit close to the top. Perfect. So once you're happy with your poster, go up to share and then you've got the options here to download it. Click on file type. You can download it as a JPEG, which will work very much like an image. Obviously your PNG file and a PDF if you want to do so. I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.